गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज शफी फ्रॉम डॉन बॉस्को पीयू कॉलेज चित्रदुर्ग. इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी सॉल्वड सम क्वेश्चंस. इन दिस क्लास आल्सो वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विथ द सेम टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. दोज क्वेश्चंस आर बिलोंग्स टू द एक्सरसाइज 10.1 इन योर एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक. इन एक्सरसाइज 10.1 we will have the third question, that find the distance between P of x1 y1 and x2 y2 when PQ is parallel to y axis. In this we will have two questions. First question is PQ is parallel to y axis, PQ is parallel to x axis. Let us solve one by one. If you observe, we know the distance between the points P of x1, y1 and Q of x2, y2. What is the distance between the points P x1, y1 and Q x2, y2 is what? Square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. That is the distance between the two points P and Q. But he is asking that PQ is parallel to y-axis. What is the distance between P and Q when that PQ is parallel to y-axis? See, here we will have xy plane, x, negative x, negative y, positive y-axis. It is origin. First question is what? PQ is parallel to y-axis. PQ is parallel to y-axis. Suppose it is P and it is Q. PQ is parallel to y-axis. Then what is the distance between these two points? What is the distance between P and Q? That line is parallel to y-axis. Let us find out the distance. Solution. Given points are what? Write down the given points. Given points or P is x1, y1 and Q is x2, y2. Okay. Next, since he is saying that PQ is parallel to y-axis, what is the condition? A line is parallel to y-axis. What is the slope of PQ? What is the slope of PQ? I mean, in our previous classes, I already told you that if a line is parallel to y-axis, then slope of that line is what? Slope of that line is find, isn't it? A line is parallel to y-axis, then that slope of that line is not defined. What is the slope of y-axis is also not defined. These things already we have discussed in our previous classes. You can see the note points what we have discussed in our previous classes. Similarly, the slope of PQ is also not defined. Since PQ is parallel to y-axis, therefore slope of PQ is not defined. Since slope of PQ is not defined, that not defined, we will use the symbol infinity. Okay, these things I already told you in our previous classes. This point I already told you in the note point. I think you can see the second video of this straight line. In the second video, I already told you about these points. Slope of PQ is not defined. Therefore, slope of PQ, how to find the slope of PQ? What is the formula? Y2 minus Y1 divided by X2 minus X1 equals not defined. This not defined, I mean, this infinity is also can be written as 1 by 0. Since 1 by 0 is not defined. What about 0 divided by 1? is 0. 0 by 1 is 0. 1 by 0 is not defined. These are the basic concepts. Now, let us find out. Before that, take the cross multiplication of it. You can take the cross multiplication now. Take the cross multiplication. Then we will get y2 minus y1 into 0 is 0. x2 minus x1 equals to 0. Therefore, x2 minus x1 equals to 0. Therefore, x2 equals to x1. x2 equals to x1. Okay. Now, we want the distance. We want the distance here. x2 is also equals to x1. Now, let us find out the distance. Therefore, PQ equals to what is the distance? PQ equals to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Right? But here we found that x2 is also equals to x1. Replace in place of x2 with x1, or replace in place of x1 with x2. Finally, we will get the distance, that is equals to square root of x1 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This x1 x1 will get cancelled, 0 whole square will come, that is equals to square root of y2 minus y1 whole square. Square root will get cancelled. Finally, we will get y2 minus y1. Therefore, the distance between the points P and Q, which is parallel to y-axis, is y2 minus y1. Understand? y2 minus y1. We know that distance that always should be positive. So that we have to use modulus. Modulus of y2 minus y1. Modulus represents that value should be always positive. Distance measured in positive quantities only. Right? If you want to take a screenshot, you can take. Let us solve the sub-question B. It is A question. Now let us solve the question number B. PQ is parallel to x-axis. PQ is parallel to x-axis. Okay. This question will be homework. If you want a hint, I will give. This question will be homework for you. If you want, I will give the hint of it. See, hint will be take xy plane. Okay, take xy plane. Now PQ is parallel to x-axis. PQ is parallel to x-axis. PQ. This PQ is parallel to x-axis. Then what is the condition? If a line is parallel to x-axis, then what is the slope of that line? Or what is the slope of x-axis? Slope of x-axis is 0. Slope of PQ equals to 0. If slope of PQ equals to 0, then y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 equals to 0. If you take the cross multiplication, finally we will get y2 equals to y1. That's it. 50% of this problem I have solved. Remaining thing you have to solve. So that this question, B question, will be homework. Let us move on to the next question. We will have the fourth question in your NCERT exercise 10.1. See the question number 4. Find a point on x-axis which is equidistant from the point 7, 6 and 3, 4. We have to find a point on x-axis. We have to find a point on x-axis. For to find a point on x-axis, he is given the hint that that point is equidistant from 7, 6 and 3, 4. You just imagine. Consider xy plane. consider xy plane. It is origin. Find a point on x-axis. Find a point on x-axis. It is the required point P. Let us consider that point will be P. Find a point on x-axis which is at a distance, which is equidistant from the point 7, 6 and 3, 4. 7, 6 and 3, 4. It will be 3, 4 and this will be 7, 6. By using this, we have to find the point P. Are you understand? Yes. Now, write down the given things. Let A is 7, 6 and B is 3, 4. Let the point A is 7, 6 and the point B is 3, 4. Next, we know that I already told you about this point in our previous class that on x-axis y coordinate is what? On x-axis y coordinate is what? 0. On x-axis y coordinate is 0. On y-axis x coordinate is 0. These things I already told you in the previous class. Now, let us consider this point P is x, 0. We know y coordinate is 0. We need to find x only. We don't know the value of x, so that I am taking x unknown value. It's an unknown value. I'm just taking x. P of x, 0. We need to find the value of x. Let P of x, 0 be any point on the x-axis. Let P of x, 0 be any point on the x-axis. Now, given condition, what he is said in the question, which is equidistant from the point, PA equals to PB, which is equidistant. He said equidistant. PA equals to PB. He said equidistant, so that distance will be equal. This graph will be accurate if we draw this in the graph sheet. Which is equidistant. PA equals to PB. Now, before that, let us apply distance between formula. Distance between formula is what? Square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Square root of x2 minus x1, PA. So PA, x minus 0. This point A, we taken as P 7, 6, right? Let us interchange this. This point A is 7, 6 because we defined in the starting itself that 7, 6. A equals to 7, 6, B equals to 3, 4. So B equals to 3, 4. What is the distance between P and A? X2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square, right? X minus 7 whole square plus 0 minus 6 whole square. X minus 7 whole square plus 0 minus 6 whole square. X minus 7 whole square plus 0 minus 6 whole square. equals to PB. X minus 3 whole square plus y 0 minus 4 whole square. Square root of x minus 3 whole square plus 0 minus 4 whole square. X minus 3 whole square plus 0 minus 4 whole square. I just used the formula that square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This formula I just used, or this also can be written as square root of x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. About this formula I already told you in the previous classes. Kindly do not confuse. I just used this formula here. Okay, we need to cancel the square roots. If we want to cancel the square roots, then what we have to do? We have to do is squaring on both sides. If we apply squaring on both sides, then this square root will get cancelled. Finally, we will get x minus 7 whole square plus x minus 7 whole square plus 0 minus 6 whole square. Minus 6 whole square is how much? 36. Okay, if you want, you can keep it as it is. Minus 6 whole square equals to x minus 3 whole square plus minus 4 whole square. Okay, now simplify it. X minus 7 whole square, x minus 7 whole square, a minus b form. A minus b whole square is a square plus 7 square is 49 minus 2ab. 2 into 7 is 14x plus next minus 6 whole square is 36 equals to next. Once again apply x minus 3 whole square, I mean a minus b whole square form. X square plus 9 minus 2 3 is 6x plus minus 4 whole square is 16. Now see the things which numbers will get cancelled. X square will get cancelled. Is there anything else to cancel? No. Now 49 plus 36 is how much? Similarly 9 plus 16 is how much? 49 plus 36, 85 minus 14x equals to next. 9 plus 16 is how much? 25 minus 6x. Okay, 25 minus 6x. Now take this minus 14x to the right, take this 25 to the left, then 85 minus 25 equals to 14 minus 6x. Okay, now here you can take a screenshot or you may pause the video. You just note down in your notebook. After this, I don't have space, so that I am going to the new sheet. For that, you just take the screenshot. Okay, now I am moving to the new sheet. Continuation of new sheet. Sorry, here I forgot to write x. 14x, okay, minus 14x. I'm just taking this minus 14x to the right. It will be plus 14x minus 6x. Okay, now I'm moving to the new sheet. Minus 25 is how much? 40 equals to 14x minus 6x is how much? Then 40 equals to 8x. 40 equals to 8x. Now x equals to 40 divided by 8. Then simplify it. Now 40 by 8 is 4 2's are 8, 4 1's are 85 minus 25 is 60. 85 minus 25 is 60. Okay, then 4 2s are 8, 4 1s are 4, 2 will be there, 4 5s are 20. Therefore x equals to 15 by 2. Therefore, x equals to 15 by 2. Now, we found the value x equals to 15 by 2. Therefore, what we have to find? A point on x-axis. Therefore, write down the conclusion that required point on the x-axis is what? On x-axis is what? P of x comma 0. So x we found 15 by 2, 15 divided by 2, then 0. That's it. Hence it is the required point in the x-axis. Are you understand? I already told you many times. I said that for this straight lines you need more and more basic concepts what we have learned in our lower classes as well as previous classes concepts we need. Otherwise you find very difficult to understand these concepts. We will have the sixth question in your NCERT textbook, exercise 10.1. Without using Pythagoras theorem, prove that the point 4,4, 3,5 and -1,1 are the vertices of a right angle triangle. Generally, we will prove the like using the Pythagoras theorem. How? AB whole square plus AC whole square equals to BC whole square. So these things we use for Pythagoras theorem, right? But he is saying that we should not use the Pythagoras theorem. Without using Pythagoras theorem, we have to prove these points are the vertices of a right angled triangle. You just think by using their slopes. So right angle triangle, what is the angle of a right angle triangle? 90 degrees, isn't it? Angle of a right angle triangle is 90 degrees. Let us construct a imagination of a right angle triangle. I am just constructing imagination figure of a right angle triangle. A, B, C. Right? It is what? It is a right angled triangle. Now, A we know 4,4, B is 3,5, C is -1,1. Let us classify. We know that if the two lines, if you observe, AB and AC are perpendicular, isn't it? AB and AC are perpendicular. If the two lines are perpendicular, then product of their slopes is -1. This line slope will be m1, this line slope will be m2. M1 into m2 equals to -1. This is what we need to prove without using Pythagoras theorem. Based on their slopes, let us prove. Let us find out the slope of m1. Joining through the points A and B. After that we will find a slope M2 joining through the points A and C. Let A is 4,4 and B is 3,5, C is -1,-1. Now slope of AB, find out slope of AB. No need to find the slope of BC. Remember, no need to find the slope of BC. We need only slope of AB and slope of AC. Then after that, we will find its product. If we get -1, then we can say that these are the vertices of a right angle triangle. If not, then these are not a vertices of a right angle triangle. Slope of AB is M1. Equals to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 equals to slope of AB y2 minus y1 5 minus 4 divided by 3 minus 4. 5 minus 4 divided by 3 minus 4. Finally, 5 minus 4 is 1, 3 minus 4 is minus 1, then minus 1. Next, now let us find out slope of AC. Slope of AC is m2 equals to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 equals to, now y2 minus y1, slope of AB is over AC we are finding, okay, slope of AC minus 1 minus 4 minus 1 minus 4 divided by minus 1 minus 4 minus 1 minus 4 equals to, so minus 5 divided by minus 5, that is equals to plus 1. Now what about its product? Now m1 into m2 equals to what? Minus 1 into plus 1, so minus 1 into plus 1. Finally we will get minus 1, m1 into m2. Therefore we can conclude that the given points are the vertices of a right angled triangle because product of their slope is minus 1. Therefore triangle AB or AB is perpendicular to AC. Therefore AB is perpendicular to AC, which implies ABC is a triangle, ABC is a right angled triangle. Yes, I don't understand. Okay, okay dear students, it is the class for today. In the next class we will continue with the other type of questions. Thank you.